Howdy folks, got a project to introduce here. This is a 1934 white seal all porcelain icebox. You can see they're talking about an actual seal animal there. When I think of a seal on something like this, I think of the door gasket, but that's not what they're talking about. And this is a block ice powered icebox. Never had an electric refrigeration system in it, but we're gonna change that. Got to do a little restoration work. I mean, obviously this one handle isn't working. All the rest of them do. So this compartment is where you put the ice block. You can see it's open up here. So your ice block is sitting in here and the air around it gets cooler because it's cold. So that heavier air drops down. Ice sits on this tray and the cold air from around it goes under here and comes out this opening. The cold air falls down here. This will be your coldest compartment. The air will move across, and then as it warms up, it'll rise back up and go back down here again into the around the ice block. Now the melt water runs down these channels on this tray, and you can see this has got a raised lip, so it drips off the ends of the tray into this trough area, goes down the drain. There's supposed to be a drain tube through the bottom of the cabinet right there. And then there will be some type of a receptacle on the bottom to catch the water. Looking up at the bottom, that looks like it's threaded, like maybe a glass, some kind of glass bottle would screw into that to collect the drips. I really don't know. All I've got is the box itself. I didn't get anything but the box and what you see. So my plan for this, I'm going to keep it where functions exactly like it did, but instead of a block of ice in here, I'm going to have an evaporator that uses refrigerant to get cold. There won't be a fan or anything like that. It's going to be a static, single large surface area that will get cold and cause air to cool off in this compartment and fall down just like the original block ice did. I'm going to try to do as minimum modifications as possible to the cabinet. I'm going to try to run the refrigerant lines through that drain hole in the bottom, so that nothing has to be cut, and gonna go from there. Still in the planning phase. I do know it will have a static condenser on the back. The compressor that I have for this is static cool, so there will be no fan anywhere on it. It'll be fanless, just like the old fridges from this era. And what I mount in here is going to be glycol filled, like a kind of like the old monitor top evaporators were, with the freezing solution. And Kelvinator and several others had that, where there's a coil inside for the refrigerant, but the actual container is filled with freezing solution, which in my case will be glycol. So I figured out this is what I'm going to use for the evaporator. And that is an Indian copper drinking water kettle. And there's supposedly some health benefits to copper. Storing water in a copper container. So this is solid copper. Ordered it off of Amazon. Got a nice texture to it. So that's going to be sitting in here on a little short pedestal. Kind of keep it in the center of this compartment. And then try to set it up where all the lines and tubing and everything is concealed. Going to see how that goes. So I got the two supports installed here. They're bolted into this bottom of the ice compartment. That was the only drilling I had to do, planning to do on the whole project. And yeah, obviously those could easily be plugged if need be. Make it look original again. This is the base plate that the copper drum is going to sit on. Be attached to that. This is the front that you'll see. And inside there, got some components. This coil here, that's the evaporator coil, and I'm not going to have a separate suction accumulator. That coil is oversized, so it's going to have a few extra turns at the top that can do the job of the accumulator. This tube here, that's the thermostat well. The sensing probe for the thermostat will go in there. I used Silfos, and I cut open and then opened up and hammered flat a piece of copper pipe, cut a circle, and soldered in there with Silfos to take care of the opening where the original water spigot was. This is where the capillary tube will go in through the evaporator. This is the return where the suction line for the compressor will attach. Then that is where the thermostat well goes in. And then inside there is going to be a volume chamber. It'll sit in the middle, and what that'll do, it'll take up most of the volume so this isn't so heavy. And also, I just want a ring of glycol around the outside for heat transfer and thermal mass. I don't want that compressor to have to run so long to chill this entire volume down. So putting this pipe in the middle just to take up space to take care of that. Plus, it's got a threaded hole in the top to support the lid so that all this will be well supported. Go ahead and assemble all that and see how it looks in the cabinet. Now that we have a good evaporator to cool the cabinet, need something back here for a condenser. I'm thinking this siding. That may look just like siding to you, but in my mind I see a condenser with tubing in the corrugations in a little frame mounted here on the back with the compressor hung below it. Ignore that compressor, that was just kind of a mock-up for measurements. So let's see if I can make a condenser out of this. And just like that, we have the proper length of tubing for a 1/8 horsepower machine attached to the back of the corrugated material. I've just tacked it with solder joints. And I'm going to put aluminum tape over this for heat transfer capability to allow the galvanized siding to be the heat sink, transfer the heat away from the tubing. This is going to be the outlet. I'm going to have a dryer mounted right here. Cap tube will come from under the cabinet and go up here and connect to that dryer. And then this is going to be the hot gas line from the compressor. You notice these two prongs coming down. I ordered a new compressor. It's Chinese and cheap, but you know, it's new. And there's going to be a cross member in here with the support. So those are extra long, and I'm going to cut them to length when I get the new compressor and see how tall it is. So I'm going to get this aluminum tape on here and then make it a test fit of this on the cabinet and see how it looks. Got that aluminum thermal conductivity tape in place. Help those tubes transfer their heat to this plate. Kind of shiny. Nobody will really see the backside of it though when this is installed. Well, that's a test fit. I think it looks okay. It's going to look even better when all this framework is painted black and these rivets are black around it. That'll make it look a whole lot nicer. And then of course when this is cut to length down here, the new compressor's in there. The cabinets that were designed to be electric refrigerator, they had a cutout in the bottom of the cabinet for the compressor. This one doesn't have that, so compressor is going to be underneath it. It can't be up in it, and that's going to make it a little less sightly. But again, this is just a prototype conversion kind of thing I'm doing just for fun. See how I can do it. But got an evaporator and a condenser. Next got to get a compressor, and then that's going to be a system. We're going to get to see if it'll work. Well, UPS came today, and they brought this little miniature compressor. Supposedly it's 1/8 horsepower, which is what I kind of spec the system out for. Capacitor start. Came with the rubber mounting feet. That's nice and small. It's going to fit down there where I wanted it to and be a little more easy to conceal. I'm getting the condensing unit assembled. You saw the condenser coil, but now we've got a bracket here for the compressor to sit on. And some of the tubing is in place here. The hot gas line going in up there, and then the liquid line into the dryer. And once this is attached to the cabinet, I'll be able to put the capillary tube in there and solder it easily. And the return line will go directly to the compressor. And then, last but not least, thermostat box. Attach right there to those two holes. Everything be nice and concise underneath there. Well, I made a heat exchanger line here. Got a capillary tube soldered alongside the return line. Got some extra capillary here. It'll be hidden behind this drum. Cap tube goes in there, goes through the evaporator coil, and the return line comes out the top. And any leftover cooling power in the vapor going back helps to cool the incoming liquid going through the cap tube, so it makes the system more efficient. So now what I've got to do is get this line fed through the cabinet and dress it up and get it hooked up to the compressor. Well, there she is mounted. Nice little rubber grommets came with the compressor. Hot gas discharge goes up to the condenser. It's where the cap tube is going to attach, and this is where the return goes. I mounted the thermostat box here. I set it back away from the back of the machine because I don't want the plastic thermostat knob to be the most rearmost part to get broken. And all of the cabling is goes in through clamps in the box. It's got a built-in clamp in the back. I've got a clip here to support the cord. I'm liking the way it looks. Now just to get that evaporator put in there and bolted down. All right, got the evaporator in there. Heat exchanger line put in. Hooked up the compressor. But like I said, this evaporator is going to get filled up with this glycol. This is what's going to transfer heat from the outer shell of the drum to the evaporator coil itself. And I'm going to have to pour it in some kind of really, really shallow container to get it in there because there's not a lot of space. I definitely can't get the 1 gallon jug in there. So that's going to take a little while to get poured in, but I want to get it filled up to about the top of this this dimpled area, because I remember from another project this stuff expands at a certain temperature, so if you fill it up at the top, it's going to come out. Vacuum pump is running. There's the lines connected at the back. Got the capillary tube and the return line hooked up. I've ordered a thermostat. Don't have it yet. I am going to try to run this after it's evacuated for a while. I'll just tie the this is the live from the cord, and that's the switch live to the compressor. I'll just wire nut those together so that it'll run all the time, and we can see if it's going to refrigerate. Now on to trying to get that glycol in there. Well, I put a little more than I planned in there, but it is what it is. If a little of it spills out, it's easy to clean up. It's just glycol, propylene glycol. amp, 163 watts. This entire condenser panel back here is nice and toasty warm. We got good things happening. You can hear something circulating in there. This is already very cold. Won't be long, we'll start seeing condensation on it. That down there is where I spilled glycol filling it up. That's not condensation yet. It's definitely ice cold. It's probably been running about 10 minutes. And a part of that time was during the charging. So I designed this system to operate with a very small refrigerant charge. With the tubular coil evaporator and the 3/16 tubing for the condenser, I bet that there's probably no more than 2 ounces in there. And it started to lose superheat, and this line get just as cold as the rest of the low side, and I actually had to remove a little bit, so I think it's the charge volume is very small. That's a good thing too. With this type of compressor, it's only got a tiny amount of oil in it, so if the system ever got, you know, while it was powered off, it ever got where the compressor was the coldest point, all that refrigerant is going to collect in the base and mix with the oil. So if you have a real small charge of oil, it can only tolerate a little bit of refrigerant getting in it before you have severe oil dilution. So with these tiny compressors, you got to engineer the system to accommodate that. With the old GE Scotch yoke compressor with 2.5 quarts of oil in it, it doesn't matter. You can put all the refrigerant straight into the sump and it'll work just fine. But this one is definitely not vintage. Down to 1.75 amps and 155 watts. Low pressure side pressure there, like about 25 psi. Been about 30 minutes of run time. Just starting to get a thin film of ice on there. I like it, it's working. If only it had a thermostat, we'd be able to see when it cycled off. But I'm going to let it run for a while and get good and cold. This is cold below it too. I can feel the cold air dropping down from around it. Still running like a top. 1.47 amps, 116 watts. We're down to about 10 psi on the low side. This tube here is just slightly below ambient temperature, indicating there's not liquid flooding back. If there was liquid flooding back, pressure, this system is running R152A, which is close to R12. So if we follow the R12 chart on the gauge, that will be roughly 0 degrees. So this is, I can tell by feeling it's not 0 degrees, so that tells me it's not flooding back to this point. I could get very scientific, you know, with sensors and all kinds of instrumentation, and it would tell me a lot more details, but you really don't need to know that. You just need to know that there's not liquid making it back here to have the system operating at its peak. It's been about 2 hours of runtime, and I've not been patient. I've been opening the door, so that was a little bit of a setback, but it's got a nice hard frost. I can barely even scratch it. I mean, it's you know, so cold that I scratch it off. It takes the time to melt on my finger. This is ice cold. Everything in this compartment is ice cold. And if I feel down in here, the floor of this is cold, and I can feel a little draft falling down from this opening. So definitely getting convective air circulation. We're down to 102 watts or 103 of power demand. Compressor sounds a lot better now that it's pulled down to a lower return pressure. It's not working as hard. My condenser, this was an unknown design, you know, homemade, but I've got nice even warmth all throughout the whole thing. So the tubing and the conductive, thermally conductive tape, everything's doing its job. It's consistently warm. And I can feel a lot of, you know, convective air current rising up. So, yeah, I'm happy with it. Only thing, I'm going to have to shut it down for the night because I don't have a thermostat, and I'm not going to abuse the compressor by letting it run all night. So hopefully that'll arrive tomorrow and we can hook it up, let it cool down again and cycle and see what the cabinet temperature does. I ordered a thermostat with a wide range of temperature adjustment because I don't really know how well that copper drum evaporator is going to transfer heat to the air in the cabinet. So therefore I don't really know how cold it needs to be. But with the wide range thermostat, be able to dial that in. Well, Santa Claus came again, brought me a thermostat. It's a Ranco, as you can see. There's a specification on it. You see it has a wide range of adjustment. That is to account for the fact that it's a big unknown as to how cold that copper drum needs to be to keep that cabinet cool appropriately. I wanted to make sure I had enough range to hit the spot. We're going to put this in and see what it does. Thermostat's in place in its box there. The sensing line goes across up into the bottom like it should. Let's go for a startup here. I'm going to put it right in the middle. And now we wait and see what kind of cabinet temperature we get after it starts cycling on its own. All right, it's been cycling on the thermostat like it should. No problems there. Going to let it run tonight and see where the temperature stabilizes. It's down to 38 degrees in the cabinet. It's about 60 in here, a little cooling off in the evening time. So we'll see what it does tomorrow. But for now, I'm going to conclude this video and say that I've got a working refrigerator made from an old block ice powered icebox. Time will tell how many adjustments it takes. But well, as you saw, the little icebox cooled, did what it's supposed to do. But I don't think I had enough surface area because this was cooling to 0 degrees, but I was only getting about 40 in the cabinet, which that's adequate for an icebox, but I want it to be able to get colder. And therefore I put these fins on here for heat transfer, and they're solid copper, just like the rest of it, soldered on with a solid solder joint. So there should be good thermal conductivity. And the fin part's on the back to kind of keep it hidden. You will see it from the front, but it's not going to be, hopefully, not too obtrusive. So now to just put all this back together and see what kind of performance improvement we get. Well, all that's put back in and soldered. Charged up and running. got a frost pattern building up. You can just barely see the fins on the back of it. Got a thermometer in there. See how it does by tomorrow. Last time with no an unfinned drum in there, I was able to get right at 40 in the cabinet. So hopefully a little bit better heat transfer, and it'll get a little bit colder. We'll find out in the morning. So it's been 24 hours, and gonna see how this thing's doing. You can see we're right at about 35 degrees in there. Got frost all over the container. Nice and cold. Got a bottle of water in there. It's nice and cold. So with that, I'm gonna call this a success. The compressor seems to run about 40% of the time. It draws about 75 watts when it runs, maybe 80 at the beginning of the cycle. I'm pleased with it. It was a lot of work to build that copper evaporator. I don't think I'll build another one like that. I'll probably try another creative approach next time. But the compressor and condenser setup back here, I like the way that turned out. That's probably going to be a design that I keep. But anyway, hope you all have enjoyed seeing this little white seal icebox get converted into electric refrigeration. It's my prototype of this kind of thing, so probably going to hang on to it for a while and look for another one to do and try and improve my abilities each time. Thanks for watching.